Welcome back. So we are in Kemmerer.
In a quarter mile, turn left to stay on US 189 North, US 30 alternate west.
And it is the first week in August. And the weather forecast is chance of rain, and it's cloudy and 57 degrees right now. But we are on Highway 30
west. Turn left to stay on US 189 North, US 30 alternate west. Continue on US 189 North for 2 miles.
So we are at 6,927 feet. So this sign said Diamondville. It must be a town right next to Kemmerer. I don't know, we'll find out, because I thought we were in Kemmerer. We gotta be in Kemmerer. Change the title to Diamondville if I don't ever find Kemmerer. Stopping at that Maverick, but it's way too busy just to get another like soda or something. Wow, so the hotels in town are pretty old. Best Western Plus is definitely the nicest place to stay here. Taco time. Unless they have better stuff on the west side of town. Store founded in 1902. Are you telling me the first JCPenney was here? That's amazing if that's the case. I need to look that up. Kemmerer,
1,000 feet. Continue straight on the alternate west, Coral Street.
So Ridley's Market is a grocery store. Looks pretty big.
Straight onto US 30 alternate west, Coral Street.
Wow, they had a cool museum there about fossils and mining. So I just passed the 189.
US 30 alternate west for 2 miles.
Highway 189 junction, which goes north to Jackson and the Tetons. Thank you. Kemmerer. So yeah, there are no hotels on this end of town. National Monument, 9 miles.
Continue on US 30 West for 73 miles.
Weird. So I got 93 new subscribers last month. That was the most I've got in 1 month ever. Pretty sure. So thanks. You guys are awesome.
Definitely makes the trees happy.
too many maps. I'm trying to rearrange the seat so I can see my map. So Cokeville is our next big town. Or I should say town. I have no idea how big it is. First time I've slept in my tent on this trip, and I didn't feel like it smelled at all. So I hope that's a good sign. You know, like the mustiness and from cleaning it, everything, it was all gone. There was no smoky smell from the campground when I came out here. Degrees. Wow, tomorrow their high is only 63. It's getting down to the mid 40s. Body showers in front of us. Should be a nice day. Yeah, I'm glad I paid for a campsite last night. It was nice to have a shower and a real bathroom. Because at first she told me the price and I was like, ugh, I could camp for free in the parking lot. It's just not very fun all the time. If I was in the car, I would do it. Maybe. down to my left. Oh, never mind. It's a wildlife viewing area. So we could go left, but I want to go right. It all goes to the same place. If you loop around. Video I made on this trip, the first official video, is coming out today. It's in eastern Washington in the scab lands and the wheat fields. Thank you. gosh. That... It's actually really nice. I forget that this seat, my power seat, is like 10-way or whatever they call it. So I've been tweaking it for the last day, ever since I slept yesterday. Trying to find, what's most comfortable. Because I use the cruise control so much. I don't need to put my foot on the gas. Awesome if I could get 100 subscribers in 1 month. My goal was to have 2,000 by Labor Day, by the end of summer. 2,000 subscribers. I basically got 1,000 subscribers. I think it was July 4th of last year, so that'd be 1,000 subscribers in 13 months, which isn't bad for me. Pretty happy with that. You guys do an awesome job of watching the videos. My I get in 1 month enough hours to get monetized, as YouTube requires an entire year. I get about 40,000 hours of view time a year right now. YouTube only requires it's somewhere 3,000 to 4,000 hours to get monetized in 1 year. So I'm really happy with that. That's kind of the one metrics I'm proud of. Side of the truck, you know, all the dust, and when I was back in eastern Nebraska, and it's still fairly clean because the roads I went on the past, well, yesterday, they weren't really dusty because it was wet, so that's good. I didn't want to have to clean the inside again. I need to clean the back seat better, potentially, once I take everything out of it. I need to figure out how I could wash my big blanket I've been using. I wonder if the dry cleaner has a washing machine big enough? They should. I'll check that out. Basically, oversized blanket cleaning service. Yeah, now that I've started doing these back roads, I really have no desire to have an RV or a trailer. I don't even know if I want a van, actually. Because I wouldn't even take a van on some of these roads I'm going on now. Even if it was four-wheel drive, I don't know if I would do it. But I think I'm happy with truck and camping. And then you can always get a hotel, you know, if you ever need to, when you're in civilization. And it's a lot cheaper than getting a van. I can buy two trucks for the price of a van and fixing it up. definitely allergic to skunk. Get my nose water. So strong. He must have just got ran over recently. Self-defense spray that smells like skunk. Oh my god, spray someone with that and you can't get it off for like 72 hours and you just stink for 3 days. Like, that would be awesome. You know, that I'm surprised they haven't done that. It's been non-lethal and you would just smell for a long time. I should patent. Cokeville coming up. Elevation 6191. Welcome to Cokeville. Well, that was Kemmerer to Cokeville. Thanks for watching.